Hi everyone, it's Jasmine. If you're watching this, it's my final unessay project for my English class where we're discussing end of the world and apocalypse narratives. So for my unessay, I chose to play The Walking Dead Season 1 by TelltaleGames. And if you know anything about their games, they're usually intense. So this game in particular is focused on decision making, and I'm going to analyze how those decisions change as soon as you enter an apocalypse, specifically a zombie apocalypse. So as you're watching and you see me make these decisions, it's really up to you to see if my decisions get better or worse as the game progresses through these next 5 episodes. Either way, I hope you find it entertaining and you gather some sort of insight from it. Thanks for watching. Oh no, I'm timed.
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it. You don't talk too much, do you?
Well, I don't know him. Oh, I can look around now. Oh. Aim at the target at the rear view. Okay. This one? The other one? Oh, shit. This is a rear view mirror. I can't drive. I'm looking.
I followed your case a little bit. You being a making boy.
What do you think?
I'm just glad I chose law and not order. Big mess of trial like that. Even if you was innocent, a lot of what happened can't ever be undone.
What happened? Okay.
I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on a 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Not really.
Too bad.
I don't care.
You might have the right to remain silent, but it don't mean I gotta be.
This dude. Okay.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Why does he know so much?
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop.
He's gonna crash.
That's government property, and I'll be for- I say so. This other time-
I knew he was gonna hit something. Not an oncoming car, someone. I don't even need to read what the other options were. So that's her first zombie. Ew. Those didn't break?
You think he's okay?
No, I think he's a zombie. I don't know how long I've been out for. Oh, I'm gonna die. Damn. Can I go anywhere else? Can I walk anywhere else? Oh my god. No! Don't bite me, don't bite me. Handcuff him to like a tree or something. That's probably too big.
Officer.
Oh fuck! Oh my god, leave. Can I leave? What do I? I don't want to look at him anymore. Where can I go?
Get away from me!
I can't back up anymore. Oh no. Dude! I can't grab it again, can I? Oh my gosh. I can't! I have to! I don't want to look at the cop anymore. I want to leave. This is someone's backyard that has like 12 of these dudes in it. Someone needs to investigate their backyard. I gotta get the hang of that. No, I think they're all in the backyard.
Anybody home? I need a little help.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Not an intruder, or one of them.
There's blood on the floor. I need to leave. Oh, a coloring book. How sweet. It's not finished. Is it rotten or is it plastic?
It's.
Get over this kitchen.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message two. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
You're going to the hospital? You're going to die.
Left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you.
Daddy?
Maybe she has the walkie-talkie. Why are you going outside?
You need to be quiet.
But where are you?
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come
home. Oh, sweetie.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats
are. Savannah. I kind of forgot the voicemails, to be honest. Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
No, they left. Oh, they left her.
Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Oh, there she is.
Press that Q button, girl.
I am pressing it. What is that? What is... Did I just die? What do I do? Okay. Oh. Did she grab my bad leg? No, don't let the little girl in. Don't let her in. Oh god, that might be her mom. Don't let her in. I think that's her mom. It looks like her from the picture, I think. What do I do? Oh no. Am I supposed to grab something from her? Oh. Oh my god. The sounds are horrible. Are you dead? Oh my god. That can't be her mom. She was in wherever she is.
Hi there.
That might have been her babysitter then.
Did you kill it?
It?
I don't know. I think so.
Oh no! She's gonna remember it! Back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
By who?
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
These both are bad options. I don't want to look for help because I'll find more people, but I don't want to get out of here when the sun goes down because then it's dark, and what if they can see me in the dark?
We need to get out of this neighborhood. It's not safe. We're less likely to be seen if we move.
That's not true.
My parents might come home.
We won't go far. We'll try to find shelter and come back here with others.
That sounds good. We can hide in my treehouse until then.
It'll be a tough climb with this leg, but that's a good idea.
Oh.
Let's go. Stay close to me. Stay quiet. We'll head out to the front yard and follow the road out of the neighborhood.
Okay.
It'll be okay. Stay near me, and we'll move as fast as we can.
She's moving really fast from my bad leg. Where is she going? Do I still have that hammer on me? What? Awkward lulls.
I found the bastard!
Are we going to die?
No.
No, I'm sure we're fine. Stay down! Georgia State Patrol!
Dude, he won't listen to that.
We're friendly. There's a little girl here.
Right.
Oh, shit.
Shit, you're not one of those things.
Well, those things can't talk.
Neither of us are.
Oh, damn, you've got a little girl.
Help us find the thing that got our buddy, and we'll take you and your daughter down to my dad's farm to safety. He should be able to fix your leg up, too.
I'm not a dad. I'm her babysitter. Her parents are out of town.
What's wrong with being a babysitter?
There you are. Let's get a move on.
We just were...
Oh, no.
Oh, shit. It's Chet.
Let's go. Get to my car. Go.
Get your buddy. What? Sir. So we're gonna run him over. Well, now he's gonna come back and get you guys. We're gonna see Chet again. I know it. The return of Chet. Do you think she's mad at me because I'm a babysitter? The other option was like neighbor and some dude. They were gonna take her away from me.
You've brought a couple guests.
We just need a little help. We won't stay long.
Good. You're welcome to stay here, but just for the night. I don't run a bed and breakfast. Jeez. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Yes.
Oh, not his daughter. He's the babysitter.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh.
Okay, then.
Good job, Clementine.
Looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Ugh.
Yeah. It's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
Could have been cut off.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green.
Herschel, like from the show.
Where are you headed before the car accident?
I honestly don't know. I was headed to jail. I don't think that was an option, though.
We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Oh.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
Sweet looking name. After her until we find her parents.
It smells like...
Manure?
Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
I missed my mom and dad.
I bet. Oh.
How far is Savannah?
Well, I don't really know where we are right now.
Okay.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
No.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck.
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable trait, lady.
Yeah.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dead. Oh,
no.
He makes up
for it. Is that what having a dad is like?
Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
Build a fence.
Yeah. Well, I need
you said that.
You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
He seems a little off.
I can keep an eye on your little
girl. He's a kid, Jasmine.
We can visit.
Yeah, but his eyes are like spacey.
So, what are you doing? Corpses aren't walking around.
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
Wow.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Can I leave this conversation?
You don't want to talk to him?
No.
Actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
Hey there, Kenny. So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out.
By who?
Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean, in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
That's none of your business.
I think I've got it handled okay. As long as I keep her safe, I think I'm doing all right.
See?
With those things out there, maybe. Sure, that's enough. But you gotta ask yourself if you're the type of guy who can do better than that if her parents don't show up.
Well, I don't think her parents are showing
I'll
up.
Keep that in mind. See you. How you doing, Duck?
Good! Drive the tractor.
No, it's reckless.
I'm the foreman. Lift with your back, Sean.
My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
I'm sorry about your friend.
Thanks. I appreciate it, man. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
Yay, we're gonna talk to Herschel.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
My parents are in Macon with my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
I was being attacked and she came to my rescue.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Mind your business.
Sure. I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar.
What did I lie about?
Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're going to have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're going to make
it. I didn't lie about anything.
If those same people get to questioning yours, you're going to be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
Oh no. Did he start the tractor?
No, I'll get my gun.
Fuck.
My leg is stuck.
Oh no.
Save him.
I don't know how. What do I do? I should have saved the older guy, but his leg is... I don't know what to do anymore. Oh no. I'm so sorry, Herschel. I mean, what was I gonna do? Punch both zombies? His leg was under a tractor. Why didn't Duck move the tractor? How was I supposed to help him?
I thought I could help them both.
Look at him. You thought wrong. And now?
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
This was not like him in the show. But I don't remember. That was like years ago.
Got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Oh my god, what if I had picked him instead of the boy? Now I feel bad because I let Herschel's son die, but there were two on him and his leg under a tractor. There's no way I was going to save him.
You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
Oh god. There's so many. Just coming out of nowhere. Dang it! They saved him for nothing! Who's he? Yes, in the business skirt and all.
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die either.
True.
When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity?
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common. God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
She's not wrong. They took a risk.
Yes, we did.
And we appreciate it. Now let's settle
down. We do appreciate
Holy
it.
Shit. Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
No, he's not.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't.
But she shot him.
We have to end this now. Over my dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No,
I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten. Shut up. We gotta throw him out or smash his head.
Kenny, stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Everyone chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily.
You shut up.
You shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here. And
last time I checked, Lily was the leader.
Right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
He's not bitten.
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
Do you? You're not acting like it.
It's Larry, right? Man, this is his son.
Look around, dumbass. I got a daughter in here. You got a daughter in here. Get your head on your ass, boy.
We've all got people in here. We can figure this out without killing anybody. There's another way.
Yeah, with a shovel.
Stupid problem.
Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter. No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid. He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch. She won't. And if she does... the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face.
Ouch.
Then, once she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl. She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three. And that boy is the ball game.
It's a little boy. I think we can handle it.
A little boy? He'll be an uncontrollable man-eater. It's not gonna happen. It is. And we're tossing him out now.
Sneaking the uncomfortable.
No! You don't touch that boy! You don't touch anybody! I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on!
I didn't mean to start all this!
You plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
Lee! I didn't mean to start all this. No, she just has to use the bathroom! No, 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 no. Get up, get up, get up! What's happening?
Man.
You okay?
Thanks, Lily. Just I think that's her name.
That's not
Lily. Who's that then?
Guys. Everybody down. Stay quiet.
We're gonna get in. Shut up.
Feed him first. He wants to yell so much.
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch. Itchy trigger finger. That was stupid. That was...
There you go. You're gonna give yourself a heart attack. That's his daughter?
I did try to get him to calm down.
We did.
Damn it, asshole. It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes. We're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
You'll get in there somehow.
Thank you so much.
Well, your dad wanted to kill us all. Permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
And I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
Okay.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully.
No one's gonna help him?
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Lily and Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Thanks, okay, Carly.
Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Why'd she look so mad?
Have you seen her father?
Well, it's his own fault for working himself up like that.
Homie's made of, like, pure injected anger.
I know, so for what?
A chance to donate anything before this all went down. You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
I'm just gonna keep flipping it over. There's no batteries!
There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
You don't know what batteries look like? Is she crazy? I won't roast her because I'm a man in this game.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
No.
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate up there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
I wasn't paying attention.
Not right now.
Alright, let me know if you want to.
Want to what? Greeting cards.
No, I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead cards.
That's a market. Batteries for the radio.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon. Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
Did she pee?
Well, the family's dead, so...
That's awful, Lee.
Yeah, well... She seems to be handling herself all right.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Lee says she spent days on her own. That takes toughness.
But you have no idea what sort of emotional damage is happening to her every second her family is gone. You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They owned this...
They, own this place. They're gone.
Sweetie.
Cat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead.
Duck's not talking.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Oh.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves.
We killed that
no,
boy.
No, we didn't.
We could have saved him together.
We did what we could.
He didn't even show up until the last second.
We made a choice that killed John. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
His heart.
How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again and I'm...
Well, you guys started the yelling.
He's got a temper.
Ah, fuck you.
Yeah, he doesn't.
I don't have to get him his pills then.
I'm gonna get back to him.
They both have a temper. Sometimes I don't want to talk to these people at all.
Hey there.
Hi.
Can I, get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
I'll see about that.
I don't want her to die. I don't want to get to know her.
Are you okay?
But I'm curious.
Yeah, I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I don't think she wants to get to know me.
Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
Well, sit tight.
Okay.
Okay.
It's not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course.
Of course I take care of Clementine. Oh, I should probably give her the battery. She's trying to fix a radio with no battery.
Should be able to get it to work now. Mm-hmm. Oh no! This was where they were? The music is really sad for this game. Are they behind here?
What's that?
This was my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop-stomping up with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that.
All of them. His brother's a nurse. A doctor. What do you
find anything?
We don't like the self-hatred. Glue that back together.
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
The world has ended out there. Who cares who I am?
If you don't think people will find any reason to turn on you, especially when the shit hits the fan, you're insane.
Whatever.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good, because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
His parents are in the locked up pharmacy.
Sure. Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers. You don't need anything, right?
No. I get hungry a lot.
Okay, good to know. And you don't have any allergies or anything I should know about.
Right? Oh.
Don't kids have allergies or asthma or just general maladies?
That's sweet.
My friend allergies.
But you're cool?
I think so.
Sick.
Okay, here we go.
You're the most non-problematic kid in the apocalypse.
Would you prefer to have
a
doctor?
Do you have kids?
No!
No.
You don't have a family?
Clementine has a brain.
parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Wow.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
His whole PhD.
You didn't answer my question.
Social studies.
All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
I hope not. It's just complicated, that's all.
Why?
It just is.
But you love them, right?
Yeah, of course. Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Oh.
Yeah.
I got into some trouble.
All these options don't seem good.
This used to be their store. But let's just keep that between you and me, okay?
Okay. Because of the trouble?
Yeah, that's right.
I hope she doesn't do that kid thing where she just repeats everything. Oh no, did you hurt her finger?
Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
Oh.
I'll find you a bandage.
In the first aid kit! It's over here.
Let's have a look at that finger.
Oh, I'm getting too attached.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it.
What does this mean?
Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
If anything happens to her, I'm gonna cry.
Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there? Lee?
I don't think they will. They want you to be safe. We'll find them if we
I don't want to lie to her.
I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Okay.
It's the remote to my dad's TV.
You think the TV works?
That's what I figured.
No TV's working the apocalypse.
I'm the one that told you that. Electricity is always the first thing to go. Then Wi-Fi. I don't know where to find this key.
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No, he wasn't.
Oh, was he bad?
He was.
He was bedding my wife, like... Seems pretty bad to me. I don't know if I would... No, maybe I would have killed him. Who knows?
Hey there, this is Glenn, and I'm kinda in a jam.
It's Glenn!
Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone?
I love Glenn. Glenn is my favorite character.
This is Lee. What's
and then I just stopped watching it.
Motor in, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones
Roman.
Got the
jump on me.
What's up? Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn. We're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, alright? Hey, Carly. It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go
Go ahead.
Did she put the batteries in wrong?
You fixed it.
Well, you put the batteries in wrong, Carly.
WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with
individuals who suspect may have been
exposed. The station is okay.
In the event of a fire, my producer's telling me we have to get off the air.
Steve.
WABE wishes you and your loved ones. God bless you all.
Oh no. You can't just leave without saying bye to Clementine.
How's your finger, Clem?
Good. It doesn't hurt so much anymore.
Good. I know I'm not your dad, but if you need anything, I'm your guy, okay?
Okay. Same.
You're my guy?
Oh, no. You know.
We're gonna try to take care of each other.
Yes. Deal.
Deal.
Let me know if you need anything.
Okay.
Okay, now I can leave.
Get down!
Guys! Oh, man, I'm glad you're here.
Glenn!
Jesus, Glenn!
Right then wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. She...
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can.
You guys are suicidal.
I'm saving her. With...
Tell him, Carly.
Think about it.
She's the one that yelled at you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
Okay.
There's the left. What is this thing? Oh, no, 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 no. Did he just bite me?
Did you click?
I clicked.
Well, you are dead.
No, I clicked it. Gushes from his eye socket. This one's not dead yet. Can't we make someone else do it? Ah! I'm gonna hear these sounds in my nightmares. Ah, too far. You went too far. Go back. I can't go back. Ouch.
Rad.
I love Glenn. Miss.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
Please. She's in trouble.
No.
Miss, we're coming in.
I don't want to come in. Here's Johnny. Okay. Are you a zombie?
You're hurt.
Oh, God.
I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
Yikes.
I told you, I said go away. I'm bit. But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Oh, Glenn,
I
no.
Don't want that. It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
Poor Glenn. Trying to find love in the apocalypse.
Okay, we'll leave.
Oh, I didn't read the third option where it said
to
kill
take care
her.
Of yourself for whatever time you have left.
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just, you know, end this and then there's no problem.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
Well, that's too far.
We can't let you do that to yourself.
Then do it for me.
We need to get going.
Give it to me, please.
This is crazy.
Please, step back.
It's just 2 seconds, just one bullet. And I can be with my family and it'll all be fine.
Miss.
Back up, please.
No, 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 no. He's gonna go off.
Whoa, take it easy. We just wanna help.
You can't.
Miss, just relax now. You need to think this through. We'll find you a doctor. It'll be okay.
That's not realistic.
All just.
No, no!
It's for the best.
Let's get out of here.
Everyone all right?
Yeah, we had some close calls, but Glenn is fine and, well, yeah, we're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Oh, Glenn.
Good to hear it.
How are we doing?
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Okay. What's wrong with him? Ew. What's that liquid coming off of him? Same.
They just
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
You're not wrong, Doug.
I think so, too. We better keep it down out of here. Look at the one trapped over there.
Oh, no! That's his brother! He has the key.
Oh, shit.
What? Do you know that guy?
Kind of.
Why are we lying?
You're from around here, huh? Could be anybody, you know. They start rotting and get all chewed up and...
Shut up, Doug. Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket. Thanks.
Did I keep the remote on me?
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
Is he gonna throw it?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. I just hope the power is still on.
You can just do it.
Is that actually what?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV.
Whoa.
Let's try.
Whoa.
Fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't?
Hooray for TV!
I got a few of them to take notice.
Thing.
It's a combination lock. Doug, you You want to get this door open?
About that.
You've got the combo, right?
No.
What?
Did anyone ever have it?
Look, man, there were a lot of those things trying to get in here.
And now we can't get back out onto the street.
We're also party to some egregious fire code violations.
Well, what now? What's the remote gonna do here?
Open sesame.
That won't work.
It could have. Have hope.
Not that universal.
The universal. Gee, Doug. Live a little. Oh, I have an axe now.
Awesome. Now to distract those things. Carefully.
You can throw that far? The brick's heavy. Oh wow. Now they're all paying attention to it.
Now's the time.
What's the difference? The thing said running. You're not running. Yeah, that's his brother.
I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I wasn't here. But knowing you were to take care of him for all of them, that helped.
I'm sorry, brother. Oh no. Not again. This is unfair. Gosh.
God. There we go.
Holy crap! Run!
Doug, what the hell? You were supposed to be on the lookout. No, why are you all moving this way? Holding the axe. No, you forgot the lock!
Girl, you chopped that lock.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that was close. But we did it. It's all that matters.
Oh, no.
Shit.
Fuck.
Hurry.
Oh no, that's gonna bring all of them. Oh no. And that door, that gate's not locked.
Doc, come on, baby, time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back!
Do it fast. I gotta get my dad out of here.
I don't plan on dilly-dallying. Honey, take Duck into the office and barricade the living hell out of the door behind me. Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here.
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then. Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck.
Here you go.
Alright, that door's not locked anymore.
Shit! You three, get on it! I'll get back as fast as I can!
Stay away from the windows.
Glenn, wait, what? What? Dog.
We will make it through this.
Doug, if we don't make it through this, you should know.
I should know what?
Huh?
You said I should know.
Shit.
Oh no.
Are you sure?
Shit.
Oh, shit. Okay then. Clementine, can you look for something to stick in between the handles? Something real strong, okay?
The cane, get the cane, it's in the office. I guess the cane's not that strong.
Did you find anything?
Nothing! Wait!
The window is through!
Go!
Thank you, Father's cane. Not Doug! Not Doug! Oh, I can't! No! Just kick him with your other foot! I don't know! Carly's a better shot! What do I do? What? I clicked that! I'm really upset.
Clementine, did you find anything?
Nothing!
The window is through!
Go!
Don't go. I'm so sorry, Doug. I'm really, really sorry. Don't show them both. I wouldn't even know how to save them. There's too many.
No, get them off me.
No. No, no!
You gotta move!
What? Let's go. I can't run. What? Wait a minute. Is this for real? What? What is happening?
Especially a good friend.
Leave that diseased heart man behind. What the heck? How is he gonna say you're not coming? Half that pack that's moving is his. I had to re-kill my own brother to get that key for your heart medicine, and you're gonna leave me behind? Huh? Your father's a bad man. Where is he? Let me at him.
I think I need to go.
Go where?
To Atlanta.
Yeah, I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Can I say goodbye?
You gotta do what you gotta do.
And I gotta do this.
I respect that.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
Oh. Don't think about that. Just think about your friends. Hi, Glenn. We'll miss you. Oh. And then he becomes a superstar for 7 seasons.
Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
Oh. I understand. They're talking!
Wait, Lee?
Doc and Clementine.
What is it?
How did you choose? We both needed you. You picked me.
I was gonna help you both.
But you helped me first.
Yeah, I did.
I just wish we both could have made it, you know?
Me too, Carly.
Me too, Carly.
Oh! Am I in a game? I'm gonna cry. I'm so sorry, Doug. There's no way I could have saved him, though. He was against the window with all of them grabbing him. I'll talk to you later.
But you know what? He wasn't.
Piece of shit.
And then...
Hey, Duck, you want to cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
What's he talking about?
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's... I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke. Glenn had the other one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad.
It's okay to be sad.
It doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad.
That's really sad.
Now it's gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep
this. Well, you have the hat.
Lee, come here for a second.
No.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
What do you want?
You like my daughter?
No.
Her dad tried to kill me, so.
Well, he did that because he knows that Lee Everett is a convicted murderer. And so will everyone else if you go near her.
I don't want to go near her.
I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
You watch your ass.
Hey, Lee, do you have a second?
No, not for you.
My dad would be dead if it weren't for you.
As he should be.
That guy Doug is dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor inn's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. We could stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
He still thinks the military is gonna roll through.
We got water, and most importantly, we got light. They're worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
Oh no! There goes the light. Is everything really going to be okay? Achievement unlocked? Okay, I didn't think that I lied to Herschel. I don't remember what I lied about. I really didn't think I lied to him about anything. What did I lie about? I didn't say she was my daughter. I told him about the police officer.
Told him you were a babysitter.
Yeah, I didn't want to just say I was some guy, because they would have taken her away. Mm-hmm. I didn't trust any of them. I saved Duck because I couldn't realistically figure out how I was supposed to save Sean. I mean, his leg was under the tractor. Obviously, Duck should have moved the tractor back, but I think he was just shocked. So he was just sitting there with his eyes bulging. But Sean had 2 walkers on him, and his leg was stuck. There was nothing I could do besides drag his body out from underneath the tractor, and that just wasn't gonna happen. When I could have just saved Duck. Duck was annoying, but at least Clementine can kind of have a friend. I think I would always choose to save a kid, even though I know that it's not the most rational decision, especially in an apocalypse where you shouldn't want to have children because they're burdens. As bad as it sounds, they're burdens on everyone. They're defenseless creatures that just make noise and don't really understand big world things that are happening. Like, they're just hungry or they're cold. They just need basic necessities. Whereas Sean is a full-grown adult. He can defend himself. But I'd probably still choose to save a child, especially a child in less of a predicament than Sean was. I think he was already a goner. I mean, the two guys already had their arms around him. They were going to sink their teeth in any second.
Mm-hmm.
So, as annoying as Duck is and as irrational as it sounds, I would have saved him. And I did. Also, I don't know what's his name? Larry, the big angry dude? Yeah, I didn't trust a single thing that came out of his mouth the whole time because he's just been yelling the second we showed up. So, no, I didn't believe him. Well, I mean, he's justified in being angry because the kid could have been bitten, but he wasn't. I mean, his mom was inspecting him the whole time. He had more of an alliance with their family than this new angry giant. I don't know who Irene is, but apparently I gave her a gun. I don't remember who Irene is. Who is that?
The girl who was bitten. That Glenn tried saving.
The
one who went kaplooey to her own head.
Oh. We don't like to talk about that suicide. It's triggering. I think that if I were in her situation where my boyfriend died because he got bitten and she could see what actually happened, of course no one would want to become a zombie. But I wouldn't want to shoot her, so I guess it's better that she shot herself. Even though she wrestled a gun out of her arms to do it. It's still really tragic, but in a way it makes more sense than leaving her behind to possibly attack other living people. So, it was sad, especially in terms of, like, Glenn's attachment to her and the short amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm a little biased because in any sort of apocalypse I would probably kill myself. Just because I think the anxiety would get to me, I would have my own heart pains, and I couldn't do it. Because I have a very large family, and as soon as one of them drops, it's over, I wouldn't be able to go on. So I'd probably also kill myself if I saw any of my loved ones turn into zombies. So I understand where Irene is coming from. But I also understand the morality behind not wanting to kill someone that's alive, like always wanting to help them, even though Lee knows that there's no doctor that can cure a zombie bite. So I get that they were trying to be good guys, but in the end she did what was best for her and for her own mind's sake, which is also valid. Who would I save, Doug or Carly? 76% of players chose Carly too. Okay. That one was really, really hard. Because the camera showed both of them in their, like, final throws almost dying. And before that, they showed them holding hands. So I didn't know that they were a thing until that point. After I had already died and had to watch the whole thing over again. And the whole time it was playing over again, I was just thinking, should I switch to saving Doug or should I still save Carly the second time? And I saved her again for the second time simply because she could shoot better. I have never seen Doug with any weapon. The only skill that I saw him having was being able to program a TV remote, which is fine, but in an apocalypse where there's no electricity and now there's no light anymore, it just doesn't seem like a practical skill set to have anymore. So I chose Carly because I think she's very badass, and I think that she'll be good for the team and for protecting, like, everyone around, including Clementine. Doug's cool, and I feel really bad for how he died. I think it was really vicious and really gruesome that they just dug into his guts like that. It was hard to watch. It was hard to decide. but I think I'm satisfied with my choice in Carly. It was hard having to repeatedly stab someone or, like, repeatedly at someone until they died. The hammer one is traumatizing. And I'm sad that Clementine had to see it, but I'm sad I had to see it. That thing was disgusting. The timed aspect also makes me nervous. I'm glad I can read kind of fast. Sometimes I don't get to read all the decisions, but it pushes you to actually make a decision in kind of real time, at least. That's the end of episode one's commentary. Tune in tomorrow, maybe. It was fun, though. I see where there's a lot of morality grayness happening, and the decisions do get harder as you go on. So I can't imagine what the last couple episodes are going to be like in terms of decision making.